Okay, here is a 62, 63, 65, I don't know, 60s Magnavox vacuum tube TV. We got our cheater cord, our watt meter. This came out of the abandoned barns, and here we go. Your high voltage. Oh, baby. Vertical is rolling horribly. Where's the back? Vertical linearity, height, and hold. Linearity, height, and hold. Linearity, height, hold. Okay. Straight out of the barn, man. Wow. Quality of this old stuff. What we got? We have vertical hold, contrast, brightness. Let me turn this thing around. That's contrast. It's brightness. Brightness is turned all the way up. Man, that's pretty bright for how fair it checked on the CRT. Chugging along at 108 watts. Oh, yeah. Wow, the quality of this old stuff, man. This sucker is working way better than this Zenith here. This has got some weird issue I've been trying to diagnose. Missing B-plus lines. This thing's straight out of the barn, man. Straight out of the abandoned house I found it in. I've done nothing to it. Absolutely nothing. Wow. It needs caps, though. You can hear it. I guess let's put a signal on it. Powering it up. It's warming up. There it is! Wow! It's amazingly sharp. Man. You can see we have some serious vertical issues. It doesn't look the best. But man, that sucker's working. Looks like the yoke is quinco torculated. It's actually working, man. Down here. Trying to do this one-handed is impossible. Slowly getting worse, too. Put my finger between the vertical lines. Jeez, let's put some double dribble on. Look at this, man. Jeez, spaced out. This is not meant for this TV. Man, it looks very good, though. The CRT, it checked weak. But it produces a pretty darn good picture. one-handed. Violation. Dude, it's slowly getting worse, too. I think the capacitors are about ready to have a fit. This is slowly shrinking, and that is slowly getting bigger. But... oh, yeah. The contrast affects the volume. Yeah, it's it looks pretty good. Thanks for watching.